We get the idea of dress right, dress. Now, sometimes the colonel may be smarter than the general, but there's an order if everything is to go as it is planned. No husband should have to fight in the ring and fight in the corner. No boxer ever will win like that. It is your task to make the home a place of love, for you model before him the love that the church ought to have for Christ. To the husband, it says, love your wife as Christ has loved the church. I don't believe that when God looks at me, he swoons and thinks about how pretty I am. But I think that God looks at me with all of my imperfections, and he sees what I can become in him. Says that Christ is coming back for a church without a spot or a wrinkle. That those wrinkles are the pains of her past, her historical hurts. And your job is to love her through the pains of her past. You accept an awesome responsibility because, in essence, you become the pastor, the priest of your house. You become one who leads the family in the worship of God. She is to submit, but she is not to be forced into submission. She is to be loved so completely until the Bible says that that perfect love cast out fear. When you love her completely, she trusts that you're the one who will protect her. Two of you come, and you come now not only to bring who you are, but you bring your different experiences, your family, your culture. The Bible tells us that the mystery of God is that he's working to bring all things together unto himself. I charge you both to embrace with vigor, with zeal, with fervor, the challenge that is before you. Having said that, do you take this man to be your lawful wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forth, for better and for worse, in adversity, in prosperity, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, do you promise to cleave unto him only, so long as you both shall be here? I think she meant that. Do you take this woman to be your lawful wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, in adversity, in prosperity, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others to cleave unto her only, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Would you turn and face each other? The words I'm about to ask you to repeat are the words spoken to Naomi by Ruth. They are some of the most beautiful words ever written, I think, in the English language. Would you repeat after me? Entreat me not to leave you or to return from following you. For where you go, I will go. Where you live, I will live. Where you die, I will die. Your people shall be my people, and your God shall be my God. The wedding ring is a symbol of love in two ways. First of all, it is made out of pure metal, signifying the purity of love. Secondly, it is circular or unending, which signifies that love ought never to end. Of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The lighting of the unit, it can symbolize the joining of two family lights into one light.
Come asking you, Lord, to bless this unit. union between Mia and Augie. But truly, I think in my heart they belong together. Father, I ask that you help us as a people to help them when they're running into trouble. Help us to just be there for them as well as they are there for us. Allow my wife and I to continue to be the type of friend that Mia can depend on and lead on, and then bring Augie into our fold as well. Father, we ask that you just bless them with an outstanding marriage, bless them with a long marriage, and when they run into trouble, allow them to come running to you because you are the problem solver. Father, I ask that you bless everyone here, bless everyone involved at the reception, and may we get home safely. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Inasmuch as Augustine and Mia have pledged their troth one to the other and signified the same, each with the giving and receiving of the ring, I now pronounce that they are man and wife. What God has joined together, let not man put asunder. Oh, you may kiss the bride. They were going to wait on that one. Join us now in an age-old celebration, a custom that dates back even to slavery time, when weddings were signified by the jumping of a broom. Would you? Today, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Augustine Ramirez. Would you join me in celebrating this couple? You are excused. Go, my friend, and the Lord be with you.